Dear student, how are you? Today we are in our chapter Chemical Kinetics, some basic concept and tricks I will give in this video, and we will discuss some shortcuts, how to get very fast answer from this chapter. Concept and tricks and formulas here we are going to discuss. So watch full video, not for few minutes. It will be beneficial for you. First of all, unit of rate constant. How to get the unit of rate constant very fast? So here is the trick. Mole per liter rest to 1 minus n second inverse, otherwise time inverse, whatever it is given in second, minute or hour, it should be minus 1 fixed. This is unit of K. Here n is the order of reaction. N is the order of reaction. For getting the unit of K for zero order reaction, so there should be zero mole per liter. Otherwise, we are more simplifying this 1 minus N liter raised to minus 1 raised to 1 minus N. So liter minus 1, 1 minus n, it should be minus 1 n plus n, so L n minus 1. So here should be L raised to, here 1 minus n, L raised to liter, and second inverse. Put down value 0 of instead of n, so mole per 1 minus 0, liter per 1 minus 1, second inverse. So here 0 minus 1, yes, 1 minus 0 means 1, 0 minus 1 means minus 1, and second inverse. This is our unit of for 0 order. Now what about first order? Put down value 1 here, 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, rest to 0 means 1, 1. So only second inverse, unit of our first order reaction. What about second order? Many times asked in different exams this type of questions. So here is mol 1 minus 2 liter is to 2 minus 1 second inverse. 1 minus 2 means mol inverse. 2 minus 1 means 1. Both are different. Here is small, here mole inverse. Liter inverse, liter. Understood? Now for getting the unit of 3 by 2 order of reaction. So here simple mole raised to 1 minus 3 by 2 liter raised to 3 by 2 minus 1 and second inverse. So 1 minus 3 by 2 means 2 minus 3 by 2. So there will be mole raised to minus 1 half. Now 3 by 2 minus 1 means 3 minus 2 upon 2. So there should be plus 1 by 2. So liter raised to plus 1 half. And second inverse of 3 by 2 means 1.5. Whenever order of reaction is 1.5, the unit will be like this. Understood? This is our unit of K. We can easily derive. Sometimes in the question, it never gives order of reaction. So with help of unit, we have to decide if K rate constant is given in the question. So with help of its unit term, we have to decide the order of the reaction. Suppose AA plus BB gives a product. So differential rate law. Differential derivative rate law will be minus dA upon dt minus dB upon dt for k a rest to x and b rest to y. Here rest is reference to A, order of reaction is x, with reference to B, order of reaction is y. So total order reaction is n. X plus y. This is a differential rate law expression. And now I am giving you example. Ammonia. N2 gas plus 3H2 gas gives 2NH3 gas. For this reaction, minus D N2 by DT minus, here why minus? Yes, rate is not minus, actually decreasing of concentration indicates a negative. Here minus 1 by 3 dH2 upon dt equal to plus 1 by 2 dNH3 upon dt. This is the rate term. Then we divide by 1 by 3, so now it is equal. Sometimes in the exam ask like this question: if with reference to nitrogen rate of reaction is 2.5 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. Yes sir. So with reference to hydrogen and with reference to ammonia, rate of reaction will be, this is the unit of a rate, not rate constant, rate of reaction. So actually rate equal to concentration upon time, concentration in mole per liter, time in second. So mole per liter per second, it is fixed. Unit of K is different for different reactions, but the unit for rate remains constant unit. Now what about, we have to compare these two values. So when we compare, minus d N2 upon dt is equal to minus 1 by 3 d H2 upon dt, 3 comes here. So minus d H2 upon dt will be 3 times minus d N2 upon dt. So 3 into 2.5 10 raised to minus 4. So our getted value 7.5. This is a mole per liter per second. With reference to hydrogen, rate of reaction is this. Now with reference to ammonia, so we have to compare these two values. So minus d N2 upon dt derivation form, 1 by 2 dNH3 upon dt. So here dNH3 upon dt will be twice minus d N2 upon dt. And now 2 into, multiply this value, 2.4 10 raised to minus 5, 4. So 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. This is our answer. This type of question asked many times in the NEET and JEE main. Now, one by one, I am giving you. Now, what weeks is remaining? Watch. Now, we are going to comparison of rate in mole per liter and atmosphere per second. Suppose reaction is given R2P. So concentration upon time is the rate of reaction. If our reactant in gaseous state, so atmosphere upon time. Here concentration means mole per liter per second. Here atmosphere per second. Now relation between them. Rate in molarity per second. We have to convert in the atmosphere per second. So everybody knows the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. So here P equal to nRT upon V. N upon V means the concentration. Yes, mole per liter is concentration. So now P upon RT is equal to concentration. Both side we are taking derivation. So dP delta P upon delta T into RT is equal to delta change in concentration upon delta T derivative form. This is relation of rate in concentration and in the atmosphere. Understood? Now what is the rate in the differential rate equation? There is a problem. What problem I am taking? If three reactants are reacting, AA, BB, CC, and gives a product. So here our rate will be K A raised to A. No, A raised to X, B raised to Y, C raised to Z. So this mole stoichiometric coefficient is not similar with exponent. This is the order of reaction. Reference to A, order of reaction is X. Reference to B, order of reaction is Y. And with reference to C, order of reaction is Z. So total order of the reaction should be rest, addition, sum of the rest of the its concentration in the rate law. Problematic for that, if concentration is known, then we can derive rate of reaction. But after a few minutes, rate of the reaction will be how much we never define. That is the problem. Reaction is just started and concentration is known, so we can derive rate of reaction. But before reaching, after a few minutes, rate will be how much, so we can't define by using this reaction. So integrated rate law is more convenient. We will discuss about it. Now in our syllabus, only two type of order of reactions are in detail, zero order and first order. Now first of all, zero order reaction, integrated rate law. K is equal to R0 minus RT by T. Understood? R0 means initial concentration. RT means at T time concentration. RT. K is rate constant for zero order. Here, sometimes in different books, like this, both same. A0 initial concentration, AT concentration at T time. We are using this equation, we get some rate of reaction at any time very easily. K is constant. R0 concentration of reactant at starting time, it is known. If we have to derive after 15 minutes rate of concentration, so we can derive this value. Out of 4 variables, 3 is known, 4th one we can derive. Once RT is derived, so in the rate equation put out, and it gives rate of the reaction at any time. This is very convenient and widely. Now, asked in exam many plots, K into T is equal to RT minus R0 minus RT. So here RT will be minus K into T plus R0. Minus value comes in the left hand side, became positive, positive became negative. We are comparing this equation with the linear slope equation, y is equal to mx plus c. And when we draw a plot graph on y axis of concentration at different time, on x axis there is a time. With the passing the time, what happens? Concentration of the reactant decreases. And intersect on y-axis, it gives constant, which is initial concentration R0. And slope is m minus k. Yes, slope is minus k. So we can define, sir, in another word, if graph plot RT versus T is linear and decreasing, so we can say our reaction is the zero order. And slope of this graph gives a rate constant. This value divided by this gives m, and m equal to k means rate constant we can derive, sir. Now T1 off for zero order reaction, yes sir. T1 off half life from time for zero order reaction is equal to R0 by 2k. Everybody knows the half-life time for zero order reaction is R0 by 2k. Here R0 means initial concentration. K means rate constant. Yes. So we can say half-life period of zero order reaction is directly proportion with the initial concentration. It means that if initial concentration is changed, then T1 off will be changed. Understood? Yes. If initial concentration is 1 molarity, it became half from 1 molarity. So 0.5 molarity. So here T1 off is supposed to 2 hour. So from 0.5 to 0.25, T1 half will be changed. Why? T1 half depends upon initial concentration. It means here initial concentration is high, so T1 half will be high. Initial concentration decreases, so T1 half here will be decreases. It will be less than 2 hour. Yes, understood? And now with decreasing in initial concentration. Initial concentration when different, then T1 up will be different. And T1 up is inversely proportional with rate constant. If value of k is high, t1 up will be less. Value of k is less, value of t1 up will be high. For zero order, I am talking about only zero order reaction. Now, what about first order reaction? Yes. Come to the point of first order reaction. Everybody knows integrated, not differential. Integrated rate equation for first order reaction is k equal to 2.303 upon t log r0 by rt. Here k is a rate constant for first order reaction. R0 initial concentration. Rt at t time concentration. We are simplifying this k into t upon 203. Division comes in a minus. Law of logarithm here used. So log rt here became plus this one here. K into t upon 2.303 plus log r0. Understood? This equation we are also comparing with linear slope equation y is equal to mx plus c. And when we take a plot log rt on y axis, x means time on x axis, so we get a straight line decreasing, and intersection on y axis gives a log r0. Understood? Now m is a slope, so m is equal to minus k upon 2.303. Understood? And now from the slope, and when we multiply value of slope by 2.303, so it gives rate constant. Intersection gives log r0, and anti-log of it gives the initial concentration. We can derive some. If we have to take linear form, so we have to multiply this equation by 2.303. So it will be cut here. 2.303 means linear rt k into t plus linear r0. So on y axis there will be linear rt, on x axis time, and intersection gives linear r0, not log r0 now. See. And slope will be only minus k. Right, k we can derive. So we can say if our graph linear rt versus t, otherwise log rt versus t, is linear and decreasing, then we can say our reaction is a first order. Understood? In zero order, r versus t should be linear for zero order. For this one, linear rt versus t, otherwise log rt versus t. Now what about half-life period? Yes, now our trick is going to start. 1/2 0.693 upon k means 2.303 log 2 upon k. This is half-life period of first order reaction. You can see our t1 up is not depending upon initial concentration, but inversely proportional with rate constant. So we can see initial concentration is 1 molarity. Half-life period is 2 hours. It became 0.5. Now from 0.5 to 0.25, it takes the same time. So in the first order, initial concentration whatever became half, it became half, the taking time remains same at every. I give you question. In the first order reaction, concentration of reactant is 2 molarity. And half-life period is 2 hours. So after 8 hours, remaining concentration will be, without using any, this trick is only applicable for first order reaction, not for zero. Initial is 2 molarity, it became 1 in 2 hours. Once again in 2 hours, it became 0.5 from 1. Once again it became 0.25 in 2 hours. Once again it became half in 2 hours. So now you can count 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. So 8 hours is completed. So after 8 hours, initial concentration from 2 molarity to became 0.125 molarity without using any formula. Understood? Now for nth order reaction. Yes sir. T1 half, samjhe na? Everybody understood? 2 molarity to 1. From 1 to 0.5, it is up from 0.1 to 0.25. So 2, 2, 2, 2, 4 times, 8 hours completed. So after 8 hours, it became, at every 2 hours, it became half. Taking time same, in first order, not in zero order. Taking time remains same. Became half in every half-life time. This is our trick. For nth order reaction. For nth order reaction, that is the formula T1 is equal to R0 raised to n minus 1. Universal formula. Nth order. Suppose n is equal to 0. So here will be 0 minus 1. So R0 raised to 1. Minus 1. It became positive on upward. So in zero order, we know T1 half is directly proportional with the initial concentration. Now what about first order? 1 minus 1, 0. So T1 half is not depending on initial concentration. It is not depending on initial concentration. Now for second order, here n is equal to 2, so 2 minus 1, so it is 1, so 1 upon R0. Initial half-life period for second order is half-life period of the second order reaction is inversely proportional with the concentration. What about third order? 3 minus 1. So, inversely proportional with initial concentration. So, in many reference books, there is the given A. A means the initial concentration. We are using as a R0. Now, for the first order, we are using different kind of rate equations. Yes, one by one. For the first order, reaction, our simplest 2.303 upon T log R0 by RT. R0 means initial concentration. RT means concentration at T time. This is very helpful. Integrated. K is constant. R0 is known. After T time, concentration will be how much? We can define, sir. And if once concentration at T time defined, so we can define the rate at particular time. So it is more convenient. Another form of it is 2.303 upon T log A upon A minus X. Here A is the initial concentration. X means decomposed, used. So remaining amount will be A minus X. Otherwise, reaction is not, we are not studying from starting in the time of interval. At T1 and T2 time. So log R1 upon R2. T1 and R1. R1 means concentration at T1 time is R1. And concentration at T2 time is R2. So we can define K also. Otherwise, 2.303 upon T2 minus T1. Log A minus X1, A minus X2. Why? A is initial. At T1 time, used amount of reactant is X1. So remaining A minus X1. At T2 time, used amount of reactant is X2. So remaining A minus X2. Yes, sir. We can use, sir. Now, average life for first order reaction. This is important thing. Average life for first order reaction. Average life of first order reaction. Lambda is equal to 1 upon k. Inverse of rate constant. So now formula for first order 0.693 upon T1 alpha. Upons comes here. So 1 upon 0.693 means 1.42. So average life of the reaction first order, not for zero, 1.4244 into T1 alpha. Now, our trick, we are going to start. What is our trick? How to save time in the exam? Relation between T1 of NT X percent decomposed. Yes. T1 of means 50% decomposition. Tx percent means how much percent? So find out. Question asked like this. T1 of is given. If 70% reactant is decomposed, then find out time. Yes. Suppose 70% reaction is completed. Means reactant 70% is decomposed. So taking time will be. So there is a shortcut. So K is equal to 2.303 upon T. Log 100 upon 100 minus X. Why X? 70% is decomposed. Here we are taking remaining concentration. Initial is 100, 70% means X percent is decomposed. So remaining comes downward, 100 minus X. So here time of the decomposition of x percent will be 2.303 upon k log 100 upon 100 minus x. Now what about t1 of? We know t1 of is 0.693 upon k. Otherwise, 2.303 upon k divide both. So t1 of upon tx percent will be 2.303 upon k. Here 2.303 upon k log 100 upon 100 minus x. It will be cut. So t1 of upon tx percent will be 0.3010 upon log 100 upon 100 minus x. This is shortcut. If t1 of is given, I am giving you. If t1 of is given, and tx percent we have to derive, direct put down value here x, so it gives our answer. I am giving you a question. This formula is also applicable for first order. Yes, these are shortcut of first order. In a first order reaction, T1 of is 1 hour. Find out if reactant is 70%, sixty percent decomposed. 60% is used. Direct t1 of upon t70 here 0.3010 low 100 x means 60. So why we are substituting? Because of taking remaining. So 0.3010 upon log 100 upon 40. So here 0.3010 10 by 4, so log 2.5. value of log 2.5 0.3979 here 0.3010 So here T1 of is given 1 hour. T60 we have to derive. So T60 decomposition time 0.3979 comes here upon 0.3010 and upon 1. So it gives 2.187 hour. When reactant is 60% decomposes, taking time 2.187 hour. Understood? Now what about relation between reaction is x percent and y percent is decomposed? Yes, sir. Comparison of it. Taking time of decomposition of x percentage and decomposition time of the y percent is t, and we are comparing both. So Tx percent upon Ty percent log direct 100 upon 100 minus x log 100 upon 100 minus y. If x is none, then y we can derive. Y is none, then x we can derive. 30%, suppose this one, here is 70. So here 100 minus 30, so remaining 70. 70% decompose, remaining 30. 100 minus 70, so 30. Suppose 90%, so here is 90. Here is 99%, so 99. Clear? We can derive. Now another formula is of the decomposition. If x percent is remaining, this formula for decomposition, decomposed means used percentage of the reactant. R is x percent used and y is reactant R is x percent used, and whenever reactant is y percent is used, means decomposed. In this case, we can use this formula. But if x percent and y percent remaining concentration is x percent remaining of reactant at T time, and concentration of R is y percent remaining. So in this case, Tx percent upon Ty percent, there will be log 100 upon x upon log 100 upon y. This formula. What? Here not, why not subtracted by 100 minus x? Here we are actually taking in our formula of the rate constant, here actually we are taking initial concentration upon remaining. So if initial is A, so 1 minus decomposed, so remaining is A minus X, but here already remaining is given, so now need to take initial, so A upon X, so 100 by X. X percent is remaining concentration given. I am giving you. In a first order reaction, initial concentration is 1 molarity and 30% remains reactant at 25 seconds and at 60% time will be if 30% remains now sorry it is 20% remaining is 30% in 25 seconds. So remaining quantity is 20%, so time will be, so we can derive this. Here put down value 25 upon Ty like this. Tx 25 second, Ty percent we have to derive, log here remaining is 30, here is remaining is 20. So 25 upon t log 10 minus log 3 upon log 5 0.4771 here 6990 1 minus 0.4771 divide by 0.6990 0.3174 So T will be 25 upon 0.3174. So T y percent is remaining. So 25 divided by 0.3174 78.76 remains 20% after 78 seconds. These are the shortcut. I hope you enjoyed my lecture and like my video. Share it to your friends and subscribe my channel. We will meet with another shortcuts in our next lecture. Till then, bye.